Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Priya Sapaha. Today we will discuss structure and functioning of criminal courts in India. In India, the administration of criminal justice is carried out through magistrate courts and session courts. Criminal law is a combination of three acts. The first is Indian Penal Code, second is Criminal Procedure Code, and third one is the Indian Evidence Act. The Indian Penal Code is a substantial law in which all the offences or crime has been described and the punishment of those crime has been described. The second is Criminal Procedure Code, which was enacted to carry out the process of the administration and enforcement of the substantive criminal law. And in addition, the Indian Evidence Act was enacted to guide the process of investigation and trial. So, the criminal law is basically a combination of these three acts. Now, let's discuss hierarchy of criminal courts. Section 7(1) of Criminal Procedure Code states that the state government shall establish a court of session for every sessions division. The judge of the session court is appointed by the High Court. In the hierarchy, session court is followed by judicial magistrate of class 1 and the judicial magistrate of class 2. In metropolitan area, it is followed by chief judicial magistrate and metropolitan magistrate. Executive magistrate is one of the classes of court only while performing judicial function. All these categories we will discuss when we will discuss these things in detail later on the slides. So let's discuss the hierarchy of the Indian criminal courts. At the Supreme, there is Supreme Court. Second is High Court. Then Court of Session. Then Judicial Magistrate of First Class. And in the metropolitan area, they are called as Metropolitan Magistrate. Then Judicial Magistrate of Second Class. And there are Executive Magistrates also. Let's discuss first and foremost Supreme Court of India. Although I have made a separate video on Supreme Court, you can refer that video if you want to know the detail of the jurisdiction of Supreme Court. So according to Article 124 of Indian Constitution, there shall be a Supreme Court of India. The constitutional power and jurisdiction of Supreme Court have been defined from Article 124 to 147. Then the Supreme Court is meant to be the highest court of appeal, which takes up appeals against the verdict of high courts. Supreme Court at the apex of Indian judiciary to uphold the Constitution of India, to protect the rights and liberties of citizens, and to uphold the values of rules of law. So, it is also known as the guardian of our Constitution. Let's discuss some of the points of the jurisdiction of Supreme Court. The detail, as I have mentioned, is already in a separate video. So the jurisdiction of Supreme Court are, first one is original jurisdiction, the second is advisory jurisdiction, third is law declared by the Supreme Court binding on all courts in India, fourth as a court of record and has a power to punish for contempt, fifth highest court of appeal in the country, and last is writ jurisdiction. The next is High Court. The High Court stands at the head of the judiciary in a state. It enjoys civil, criminal, ordinary, extraordinary, general as well as special jurisdiction. The High Court also enjoys an original jurisdiction in respect to testamentary, matrimonial and guardianship matters. Each High Court has supervisory power over subordinate courts under it. Each High Court, being a court of record, enjoys the power to punish for its contempt as well as of its subordinate courts. Now the jurisdiction of High Court. The first one is court of record. The second is original jurisdiction in civil and criminal matters in the case of some High Courts. Third, it has power to punish for contempt. Fourth, appellate jurisdiction in respect of criminal and civil cases decided by subordinate courts. Then, revision jurisdiction conferred under the Civil Procedure Code and Criminal Procedure Code. Then, writ jurisdiction, and then the administrative jurisdiction over subordinate courts. Coming to next is Court of Session. As per Section 9 of CRPC, the court is established by the state government for every sessions division. The court is presided over by a judge appointed by the High Court of that particular state. The High Court may also appoint additional session judges and assistant session judges in this court. It has a power to impose any sentence, including capital punishment. Next is Court of Judicial Magistrates. According to Section 11 of CRPC, every district not being a metropolitan area, there shall be established as many courts of judicial magistrate of the first class and the second class as the state government may, after consultation with the High Court, specifies. The next is, according to Section 15 of CRPC, a judicial magistrate is under the general control of the session judge and is subordinate to the chief judicial magistrate. Court of Judicial Magistrate of First Class are at the second lowest level of the criminal court structure in India. In terms of Section 29 of CRPC, a judicial magistrate of first class may pass a sentence of imprisonment for a term not exceeding 3 years or a fine not exceeding 5,000 rupees or of both. Next is Chief Judicial Magistrate and Additional Judicial Magistrate, etc. In every district, not being a metropolitan area, the High Court shall appoint a judicial magistrate of the first class to be the Chief Judicial Magistrate. A Chief Judicial Magistrate may impose a sentence except death sentence, imprisonment of life, or imprisonment for a term exceeding 7 years. A Chief Judicial Magistrate shall be subordinate to the session judge, and every other judicial magistrate shall, subject to the general control of the session judge, be subordinate to the Chief Judicial Magistrate. The next one is Metropolitan Magistrate. The town having population exceeding 1 million could be declared as metropolitan areas, like Delhi is a metropolitan area. A metropolitan magistrate is under the general control of the session judge and is subordinate to the chief metropolitan magistrate. The Court of Metropolitan Magistrates were created by Section 16 of the CRPC, and the Court of Chief Metropolitan Magistrate and those of additional chief metropolitan magistrates were created by Section 17 of the Code. Section 18 of the Code also provide for special Metropolitan Magistrate. The next is Executive Magistrate. Usually people get confused between the Judicial Magistrate and the Executive Magistrate. Executive Magistrate are officers from Indian Administrative Services or State Administrative Services. Executive Magistrates are under the control of the state government. In every district and in every metropolitan area, the state government may appoint as many persons as it think fit to be the executive magistrate and additional magistrate. District magistrate, that is DM or collector, are always an IS officer appointed by state government. The state government may appoint any executive magistrate to be an additional district magistrate, and such magistrate shall have such of the powers of district magistrate under this code or under any other law for the time being in force as may be directed by the state government. Now the hierarchy and power of executive magistrates. On the top, it is DM, that is district magistrate, popularly known as collector. Second is ADM, additional district magistrate. Third is SDM, Subdivisional District Magistrate. Now the power of Executive Magistrate. Power to pass injunction, power to stop public nuisance, power to prevent unlawful assembly, power to prevent disorder or apprehension of danger or breach of peace when a dispute concerning land and water, power to attach such subject of dispute and to appoint receiver, power to issue search warrant, power to hold inquest of unnatural or suspicious death, power to take Dang declaration, power to make inquiry on custodial death, power to justification of police firing. The next category is Special Executive Magistrate. Under Section 21 of the CRPC, the state government may appoint Executive Magistrate to be known as Special Executive Magistrate for particular areas or for a performance of particular functions, for instance, election or calamities or any other contingency, and confer on such Special Executive Magistrate such of the powers as are conferable under this code on Executive Magistrate as it may deem fit. Now let's discuss in brief the sentences which may be passed by the criminal courts. The first one is Supreme Court and High Court. They may pass any sentence authorized by law. The second one is Session Judge or Additional Session Judge. Any sentence authorized by law, but sentence of death is subject to confirmation by High Court. Third is Assistant Session Judge. They may pass imprisonment up to 10 years or and fine. Fourth is Chief Judicial Magistrate or Chief Metropolitan Magistrate. Any imprisonment up to 7 years or and fine. The next is Judicial Magistrate of First Class or Metropolitan Magistrate. Imprisonment up to 3 years or and fine up to ₹10,000. Last is Judicial Magistrate of Class 2, imprisonment up to 1 year or and fine up to ₹5,000. This is all about the structure and functioning of criminal court in India. Hope you like the video, and this is very precise video. If you want a detailed note, you may visit to my website, that is priyasepaha.com. And if you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe for more videos like this. Thank you.